There we go. Hey, long time no stream. But here we are. We're gonna keep going with Kotomi's route today. We are on April 23rd. Okay. Hey, wow! Immediate response. Hi, Beatrice, how are you? You were faster than stream elements. Oh, sorry. It's already past 10 in the morning. If I walk to school from here, I'll start the day during third period. Typical, the seat next to mine is vacant. I take off my bag and drop down into the seat, dejected at the thought of having the zombie my way through another class. There's nothing else to do but look out the window. Been waiting for me? Aww, that's so precious of you. Sorry I was a bit late. Wait, what did he say before? How do I go back? I don't know how to go back. Anyway. I stopped in the middle of a sentence, I didn't realize there was a bit left. Break time, finally. Two students sitting in front of me are engrossed in absurd gossip, reference book still in hand.
Ghosts.
It's a stupid conversation, but whether or not I want to hear it, I do.
その女性と知ってるやつがいてさ、そいつが言うには絶対幽霊だって。
マジかよ。
ああ、その女性とはね、2年前に交通事故に遭ってるんだ。
Oh.
長いこと入院してたらしいんだけど、結局助からなかったんだって。
I did read it. I read it yesterday morning. It was such a cute little thing.Thank you for recommending it. Not sure if I would have done it by myself.
事故に遭ったのがまだ入学して間もない頃だったらしくてさ。高校生活を満喫できないままで未練が残っちゃって。それで霊になって遊びに来てるんだってさ。ちょっと悲しいお話だよね。
I think we've heard this before though. Yeah, I can skip it.
でもさ。
うん?
I mean,
その話をしてるやつってさ、同じ3年だろ?
ああ。
つうことは、あれだよ。
なんだよ。
俺たちの興味をさ、
Yeah, distract us from studying. I remember this part.
してるんだよ。
え?
つまりさ、ライバルを減らそうとしてるんだって。
Yeah, okay. That's the conclusion of that conversation. The class bell rings. I should go. Just as I'm about to stand up from my seat, I feel someone grip my shoulder from behind.
ああどこに行くんだ、岡崎。
I turn around and see the teacher's fake smile at close range.
お前4時間目の授業、まともに出とらんらしいじゃないか。今日は最初から最後まできっちり受けてもらうからな。
what am I supposed to prepare for?
問答無用だ。いいからそこにいろ。俺の顔を立ててそこにいろ。頼むからそこにいろ。何が…
He's pushing me down into my seat with freakish strength.
いいか、授業が終わるまでおとなしくしてろよ。
Satisfied, he returns to the podium. Class begins. I have no choice. I'll at least pretend to study. It's time. 30 minutes later, I take action. The teacher is busy with the lesson. However, despite writing on the blackboard with his back turned to the class, it's obvious that he's on guard.If I sneak around, I'll definitely be spotted immediately. I should be doing this brazenly. What? I stand up. As if it's completely natural, I calmly head for the door in silence. Everyone, including the teacher, is staring at me.
Okazaki! お前どこに行く気だ?
There's like no background music either as well. It's very freakish to me. It's like, where did the music go?Too late, suckers. I have an excruciating headache that's making me feel stupid. I'm going to see the nurse. Did he really have to add, that's making me feel stupid? Like, just headache is enough, I guess. I run out into the hallway. I'm not lying. About the feeling stupid part, at least. However, I'm not going to see the nurse. I'm heading straight to the bread store. Aww. I go to the first floor and turn a corner. The bread store has just opened. Hey lady, I want some buns. She asks me that with a slightly bewildered look. I'm smart, so they let me skip class. Sorry, I lied. I'll do that. Oh, lunch lady is super cool. Let's eat. Our meal begins. Today's menu is Japanese. Seasoned steamed rice, teriyaki fish, spinach with sesame, thick omelets. Kotomi stares at me until I come up for air. Clannad is a love letter to delinquents. I really appreciate it. It sure is, I guess. Yeah.
Oishii? Osakana? Chotto yakisugichatta kara shinpai nano.
No, it's great. Seriously. There's still one more piece for Kotomi, so I finish my half-eaten one. What kind of fish is this?
Sawara. Kokinjo no sakana-yasan de kirimi o yasuku shite kureta no.
She says that with a glimmer in her eyes.
Ii no ga haitta kara katte kina tte susumete kureta no.
Oh, then you got something out of it. I feel like this is a conversation two newlyweds would have. And suddenly the newlywed conversation crashes into a wall. I see, they must get around.
成長するにつれて、サコシ、ヤナギ、サワラと
Oh, that's interesting. I see, they must go through a lot.
漢字で書くと、魚編に春なの。
Oh, fish and spring. That's pretty. The perfect season for them.
魚編に秋だと、カジカで、魚編に冬だと、この城なの。でもね、魚編に夏はないの。 とっても不思議。
Kotomi is on a roll. It's getting hard to follow her, so I decide to counterattack. How do you write tuna?
魚編にある。
What about bonito?
魚編に硬い。
And sardine?
魚編に弱い。
Oh. And orca?
魚編に虎。
Oh, fish and tiger. Oh, that's pretty cool. Whale?
魚編に鏡。
Capital. Wow. That's amazing. You're a fish expert, Kotomi. I pat her head.
そんなことないの。
She gives an innocent, embarrassed smile, like a child being complimented by her father.
最後の二つは魚類じゃないし。
What a cynical child. Fish are good and all, but eat my bread too. She takes the buns out of the bag and looks at them, confused. The new bread is three different flavors in one.
3つの味?
Try it out and see for yourself.
とっても楽しみ。
Kotomi smiles softly as I take out a bottle of tea and stick a straw in it. Something is bothering me. I went too far today, so they'll be keeping a closer eye on me in the future. You know, eating lunch at this hour is what's abnormal. I don't think I can keep this going for long. Hey. Kotomi is tearing off pieces of the tree-colored bread. She turns to me with a blank look. I heard you're exempt from classes, but are you sure it's okay? Like, with your attendance days?
大丈夫.
She answers instantly. You said it without hesitation.
本当はね、2つのことだけ守れば大丈夫なの。
What two rules?
全てのテストでできるだけ高得点を取ることと
Most students here have those goals. This school awards scholarships to students who excel in sports and academics. An exceptional honor student is a great marketing wedge for them. So you're saying that your grades are so great that you don't need to take any classes?
うん、そんなことないの。聞いておきたい授業もあるし、出てほしいって言われることもあるし。
A little bit ago, a teacher pleaded with me to stay in class. I get competitive for no reason.
それにね、お勉強をたくさんしないと立派な人になれないの。
Hearing that from you sounds weird. I honestly can't tell if it's more or less convincing coming from her. How are your grades so good if you don't attend class? Does that mean you study at home? A dark shadow passes over her face at this thought.
私、小さな頃からずっとこうだったから。
That's all she says. She must have received special treatment from teachers and other students her whole life. A girl with exceptionally good grades probably gets more than just compliments and respect, though. I'm sure she's been through a lot of rough stuff, too. Let's get used to it slowly. I'll stay with you the whole way. I said that in a cheerful tone. Still, if I spend all of my time with her, it'll mess up my supplementary courses and makeup exams. I know. Why don't I get Kotomi to help me study? I'll get a personal tutoring session from the girl genius Kotomi Ichinose. She'll draw out my hidden talents one by one and my grades will skyrocket. Then I'll be accepted into a first-rate college and I'll have the time of my life. Wait, what? Isn't that a bit too far? That's 100% impossible. No, it's nothing. I pick up my chopsticks again. College, huh? Probably the only third years not thinking about the future are me and Sunohara. Whether I go on to higher education or find a job, I feel totally disconnected from the idea. Where are you applying? Kotomi could probably easily get into any college overseas. Actually, it would make more sense if she had already skipped some grades and gone straight to college if she weren't in Japan.
Mm-hmm.
You don't know what to do?
家から通えないところはダメだから。
She really is as shy as a first grader. Did you pick the school because it's close to home? She nods.
はい、ともやくんの分。
She hands me the bread that she carefully tore into pieces.
半分こ。
半分こ。Yeah, thanks. I'm about to take it, but then my eyes widen. We're doing halfsies, so why are there three pieces?
三分割した三色パンを各色ごとに二分割してみたの。
She's unnecessarily deft.
こうすれば仲良く半分こなの。
She smiles proudly. The bell rings and lunchtime officially starts. I can hear the noises from the front yard through the open window. Students eating their lunch on the grass, the sounds of them joking around with each other. Kotomi is the only one outside that circle. Although it's been protecting her all this time, it's also been isolating her. Our circumstances are polar opposites, but we're very much alike. This is the first time I've had that thought. Sixth period is followed by homeroom, then the day comes to an end after that. Sunohara stands up, his unbridled excitement contained only in the fist he repeatedly pumps into the air. Wait, you were here?
午後から隣で寝てたよ。ちなみに夢の中でお前と一本のポッキー食べてたよ。ね、今日こそは放課後付き合ってくれるんでしょ？
Yeah.
よし、行こうぜ。楽しいワンダフルが僕たちを待ってるぜ。
Sunohara picks up his bag and leaves the classroom.
で、来ないのかよ？で、今回はあんた、あーって答えてましたよね。
Well, I thought I might be able to trick you again.
普通引っかかりますよね。
Man, that was fun. Okay, you can go now.
それでしかも来ないのかよ。岡崎、お前、こんなことしてるとな。僕、他に友達作っちまうぞ。
Sunohara runs away after speaking his bizarre parting words. I grab my bag too and stand up. I'm at the usual corner of the hallway. Kotomi isn't here yet. I place my bag by my feet and lean against the wall. Who should I introduce her to today? My mind is buzzing with thoughts. The whole building is filled with after-school bustle. Students carrying their bags are walking home in a procession. Kotomi is taking a long time to show up. I wait another 15 minutes. I hear the chime for a school announcement. It's summoning Kotomi. Why would they be calling her? Is it because she's an honor student or is it about her truancy? It's hard to tell. Either way, it will be a while before she gets here. But if she takes too long, the person I want her to meet might go home. While I'm wondering what to do, the chime rings again. It must be important for the same broadcast to repeat every 5 minutes. Maybe she's somewhere where she can't hear the announcement. Or maybe she's already gone home, or maybe she's just like in her, you know, zone, reading and not hearing anything. I'm starting to get worried. Maybe I shouldn't have forced her to meet new people. Or maybe she's had a sudden emergency. I don't think Kotomi would break a promise or ignore the school announcement. Okay, go to the teacher's office, wait a little longer. I have no idea. I mean, what would we do at the teacher's office? Can we help in some way? I don't know. Let's wait a little longer. I decide to wait a little longer. Even if she were to go to the teacher's office, she'd tell me first. I usually make her wait, so this is a good experience for me. I wait for 30 minutes, but Kotomi never shows. I give up on waiting for her. What happened to her? Just as I bend over to pick up my bag, I hear the sound of campus shoes walking toward me. They stop in front of me. She's finally here. I look up and smile. You're a little late today. Well, let's go. We start walking together. Why aren't you guys working together like friends? I don't get you. Not as much as you. Huh? Not even for a second.
今日は遅かったな。 それじゃあ行くかって僕に思いっきり言ったよね。
Your subconscious caused you to imagine it because you don't have any friends. Oh my god, why is so mean to Sunohara though?
すごいひどいこと言ってるんですけど。
Then name one good friend of yours.
親友?
I leave the lonely Sunohara behind.
後にするな!
He catches up to me, filled with desperation.
お前だよ、お前!
What? This manly piece of garbage faces me head on and starts saying a bunch of stuff. Sunohara.
Okazaki.
The only funny thing about what happened was your face. The core of the story is bullying Sunohara in various ways. Tomoya's love life is merely some afterthought that's been put in at the last moment for marketing purposes. It does feel that way, doesn't it though? He's taking it to a whole new level. A complete stranger. What? I leave him behind. He catches up to me filled with desperation. Hello stranger, do you want something from me? What a lonely guy. If you insist, I guess I don't have a choice. I don't know how it ended up like this, but I decided to go with my self-proclaimed friend. Well, that's life. Oh. Illusionary World 5. Did we see this before? Yeah, we have. Fourth period begins. I'm usually lazy, but I tend to perk up a bit around this time of day. Kotomi is probably on her way to the library. I, on the other hand, am forced to kill time while staring daggers at the teacher's back. There's absolutely no opening. Rather, he's totally got eyes in the back of his head. Being truant over the past few days must have triggered this. And trapped until the lunch bell rings. On top of that, the class runs long by 5 minutes. Damn it. The moment the teacher leaves, I fly out of the classroom. It's a war zone at the bread shop. The popular ones are all gone and I don't have time to chat with the lunch lady. I try to find a couple of good ones and push my way over to the cashier. I run up the stairs. As I approach the library, a tension that I've never felt before fills the air. The sign reads open, please be quiet, instead of the usual closed. Before they take notice of me, I leave the area. I consider visiting class A but decide against it in the end. Instead, I return to my class and eat my bread alone. I chose the buns based on what I thought Kotomi would like instead of the ones I'd prefer. I'm bored out of my mind during afternoon classes. Countless minutes drag by as I try to hold out. By the time I open my eyes, the final bell is ringing. Homeroom has ended and students are leaving the classroom with their bags. Still drowsy, I look around. What is Kotomi doing right now? The library is probably open after school, so she wouldn't be there. We didn't promise to meet up, so she might not go today. Does Kotomi still have any intention of waiting for me in the first place? I think of Kotomi. I might only be introducing her to friends for my own self-satisfaction. This might be much more stressful for Kotomi than I originally thought. She's so shy and terrible at human interaction. She might have decided not to see me anymore.
Tomoya-kun, konnichiwa.
There she is.
Konnichiwa.
Aww.
good afternoon.
Precious her, bless her heart. She thought her greeting was wrong. But that's not it. Yes. No, that's not the problem. If you're so shy and terrible at human interaction, how did you enter someone else's class as if it were nothing? Wait, don't answer that. My bad. Whether or not I'm bad, you're weird, without a doubt. Don't bully her. Yeah, very. I can tell that the remaining students are watching us like we're some comedy act. Let's go somewhere else. Just come on. The moment I grab her wrist, she blushes bright red. I take this strange genius girl away from the classroom. Here should be good. Cute, yeah, she's adorable. I let go of Kotomi's hand when we arrive at our usual corner of the hallway. Kotomi's face is still crimson. Because of that, I'm starting to feel self-conscious. I'm surprised you could come into my classroom. Doing that would usually make someone embarrassed. Precious her! Yesterday, you mean after school? After saying that, she looks down meekly. Don't worry about it. I often ditch meetups too. The victim is usually Sunohara though. Never mind me. The teachers were calling for you yesterday. The moment I say that, Kotomi's expression darkens. She becomes dodgy again. She had apparently known that she was being called and ignored it on purpose. That's really unlike her. I consider asking her why, but decide against it. Kotomi will probably tell me when she's ready. Well, whatever. Right now we have to make you some friends. She responds with an innocent smile. Oh, you're getting into it. That's the attitude I'd like to see. That makes it all the more worthwhile to me. Let's see, for today, just as I'm thinking about my acquaintances, I turn around and see Fujibayashi standing there.
これ。
She timidly holds out my bag. I was so preoccupied with escaping the classroom with Kotomi that I had completely forgotten about it. You didn't have to come all the way here to give it to me. I would have gone back for it. Or I would have just left it there. It's not a big deal either way.
Aww.
I like Ryo so much. She's so, I don't know, caring about everything around her. Well, thanks. I take my nearly empty bag from Fujibayashi. Oh, this might be sudden, but I want to introduce you to someone. Kotomi is hiding behind me as usual, but I push her out in front of Fujibayashi. This is Kotomi Ichinose. She's a friend of mine. Fujibayashi remains silent, dumbfounded. She continues staring blankly at Kotomi. Kotomi is also looking at Fujibayashi strangely. It's like two small animals meeting by chance at the top of a tree. They both probably think that the other is strange, yet similar to themselves. Come on, Kotomi, say hi. Hearing my voice, Kotomi comes to her senses and bows.
Tomoya-kun, konnichiwa.
Not to him, though. That joke is getting old, so we'll think of a new one later. Fujibayashi makes the first move. She takes some cards from her uniform pocket. Awkwardly, she manipulates the cards. As expected, they fall all over the floor. Aww. She frantically picks them up. She fans the cards out and holds them to Kotomi. No! Don't look at me as if you're about to cry. She gingerly chooses three cards. Looking at Kotomi's cards, Fujibayashi is deep in thought. Then she says,
Ichinose-san, 明日は友達ができません.
Don't make prophecies that totally ignore my efforts.
Demo, uranai de so dete shimatta node.
Tell me what she got in more detail.
Spade no jack to joker to heart no jack desu.
She starts explaining the cards Kotomi chose.
1 mai me to 3 mai me no jack wa kojin wo imi shimasu.
I know she's serious, but something about this is unconvincing. Is that right?
Watashi-teki-ni-wa. その... スペードとハートなんですけど... この2つは... 先端が互いの逆を示しています. つまり... 個人同士の仲が悪いという意味です.
Oh.
さらに... 間に来た2枚目のカード。これは個人同士をつなげる役にある人を示します。That's
me?
最悪です。Your
recognition.
Hey Squid, good morning. How you doing?
ジョーカーはすべてを終わりにします。Thank
you so much for the resub.
ゲームの大富豪でもジョーカーが出されればおしまいですから。
Hey, vacation is good. It's still ongoing, actually. I'm still off this week as well. But yeah, I visited my parents. It was pretty nice. It's really hot, though, so the heat was not nice. Not at my parents' place, where we don't have AC, and also not on the train, especially on the way back in the afternoon, after the train had been in the sun all day. Yeah, it was no bueno. You are envy. Yeah, but otherwise things have been pretty cool. I'm taking it slow. It took me a little bit to get used to the idea that I am on holiday and don't have to care about what's happening at work. But I'm in the zone. I'm doing well. I've been reading quite a bit ever since I came home, and also on the train finished some books that I had started a while ago. Also read the short story that is referenced in Clannad. So yeah, That's pretty much it. Just, you know, relaxing and stuff. And streaming today. What? Hey, wait! Unable to bear this harsh fate, Kotomi tries to run off. I quickly grab her collar to stop her. You approve of those choices? Thank you. Thank you. I hope things are not too terrible for you at work and stuff. I hope you can take them step by step and get them done. Whatever you need to do. Listen, Kotomi, running away crying won't change the situation. You have to face reality. Aww. Aww. Oh my gosh. She melts my heart. Seems like it's beyond her capacity, but she tries to nod as best she can.
Uranai wa uranai desu kara. Ataru toki mo arimasu kedo, hazureru toki mo arimasu shi. Sono uranai wa uranai de atte, yogen dewa nakute, yogen dewa nai node, sono kotoba jitai no imi wa yowakute, sono.
All right, that sounds good. Happy to hear that's good. You keep going. I believe in you. You got it. You can do the thing. Fujibayashi tries her best to quell the situation. Anyway, this is Ryo Fujibayashi. She's our class rep.
Fujibayashi Ryo desu.
She's so sweet too. Super cuteness. There's something very sweet and cute about her that her sister just like doesn't have. Her sister's like daggers in her eyes and like rough edges and you know. At least that's how she feels to me. The Kyo you met yesterday is her twin sister. This is the younger one. Their personalities are different, but their dangerous natures make me think it runs in the family. How is Ryo dangerous? She's so sweet. Kotomi is staring at Fujibayashi. She timidly points at her own face.
Kotomi. Hiragana mitsu de Kotomi. Yobu toki wa Kotomi-chan.
Kyo's better? Alright. To each their own, I suppose.
Wakarimashita.
Ryo-chan te.
I guess it's just a simple personality thing. I would make better friends with Ryo than with Kyo. She's cool. Don't get me wrong. I admire her in many ways. It's just I don't think I would vibe as well with her.
Ijimekko?
No, she asks that of everybody. You did something just now to make her think you are. Well, I hope you two weirdos become good friends. She agrees. I'm glad she differs from her sister in this way. It's a figure of speech. Don't worry about it. She bows and walks away down the hallway. Kotomi must have been nervous. She lets out a big sigh. You did well back there. She managed to introduce herself well. We're making progress. Compared to Fujibayashi, Kotomi seems much more level-headed. Let's move on to the next one. I lift my bag and start walking. That's when I notice Kotomi doesn't have her bag today. Hey, where's your bag? Somewhere? That's a bit vague. How do you forget your bag? Let's go look for it. Kotomi nods repeatedly. She's definitely the same type of creature as Fujibayashi. I feel certain of that. By the time we pass through the school gate, it's already evening. We descend the tall hill side by side. After spending a lot of time looking for her bag, Kotomi is clutching it as though it's precious. She must have been really preoccupied to have forgotten about something so important to her. Hey, Kotomi. What do you want to do once you've made lots of friends?
え、えっと、うん。
Well, let's think about it again after you've made those friends. I don't think introducing her to friends has gone very well so far. I thought Fujibayashi would be easy, but it didn't turn out that way. I think about what Kotomi said. Is this really for her sake? Maybe Kotomi is just straining herself for me. These worries keep popping into my head. Kotomi and I don't speak. She just walks by my side. Hey, Kotomi.
Hmm?
Is being introduced to all these people nothing but trouble for you? Tilting her head to the side, Kotomi looks at me.
でもね、この頃はね、ちょっぴり思うの。一人ぼっちはやっぱりちょっと寂しいなって、お友達ができたらなって、ちょっとだけ考えたりもするけど、やっぱり私には難しいのかなって。
That's not true. Her worries are probably overshadowing her hopes right now. She just needs an opportunity like she had with me. Tomorrow is another day. I'm hoping that Fujibayashi's fortune telling will turn out wrong.
Tomoya-kun, mata ashita.
Yeah, see you tomorrow. I watch as Kotomi quickly walks off into the distance. I turn around. It's already getting dark. I'm used to walking alone too. So why do I keep meddling with her? I really wonder why. Third period. I'm resolved to do a certain something. I have to do battle with the teachers every day just to see Kotomi. I can't put myself in a worse situation than before. To that end, I decide to focus on class until my attention runs out. The subject at hand is geography. Australia. I think that's the country with lots of sheep. Is there sheep in Australia? Like, I'm not saying that there should not be any sheep. It's just like, is that a thing that Australia is famous for?
Sydney.
Oh, Australia's capital is in Sydney. Right, I think I've heard of it before. It's like... Che? Chiru chiru michiru? What the hell? Or some other fancy name. Chiru chiru michiru. Trying to ward off sleepiness, I reviewed a few things I know on the subject. That's right, it's Melbourne. Mel is the little sister and Bourne is the older brother. An evil witch must have turned them to sheep. They go through many trials. What? Which the two overcome together and... It's around that point that I lose consciousness. When I wake up, it's break time. I'd spend the rest of class dreaming I was having a great time with sheep. It's Canberra, actually. Okay. A big improvement, to be honest. Australia's capital is Melbourne, not Sydney. I store one useful piece of knowledge. Possibly thanks to my hard work, fourth period is a study hall. With the bell signaling the start of class, the student on day duty is passing out worksheets. I spend 30 seconds haphazardly filling mine out, then leave the classroom. I head to the usual library. I put my hand on the handle of the sliding door. Seeing that it's open, I feel relieved.
Tomoya-kun, konnichiwa.
Kotomi is reading barefoot. She hops up and smiles. You're here early. Oh, sorry for making you wait.
O-bento taberu?
It's still early. I actually haven't bought any bread yet. She seems a bit down. It's been 2 days since we've eaten together, so Kotomi may have been looking forward to it. Listen, I already thought about what to do today. She tilts her head like a little bird as she looks at me. Listen, Kotomi, what you need most right now is a proper greeting. And a proper retort. No good, your reaction time is too slow. Kotomi droops in depression, so I tap her on the shoulder. Alright, let's start training. What you talking about? It's so weird to see her say that. What you talking about? From Kotomi, it's like, what? Not the retort part, we're practicing your greeting. We work on Kotomi's self-introduction and greeting together. Trying to come up with a standard phrase that will work for everyone is harder than expected. I play the role of a stranger and make Kotomi practice again and again. I'm sure it would look odd to a bystander, but we both take it seriously. Before we know it, the noon bell is about to ring. I'm gonna go buy some buns. I'll buy the complicated sweet bread, the kind you like. She smiles a little bashfully. There's still an air of loneliness about her, though. Oh, I know, you should come with me. To the bread store. You've never bought bread yourself, right? It's okay, only the bread lady will be there right now. If you go now, you'll get to see all the kinds they sell. There's a bunch you haven't seen yet. She places her hands over her chest and thinks for a moment. She's curious about new things despite being so shy, so I'm sure she's interested in coming. After a while, she timidly asks, Oh, no one's going to bully you. Yeah, wanna go? She says it quietly, but I'm sure that's what I hear her say. Then it's settled, let's go. Her bare footsteps echo off the floor. Hold on a sec. Put on your shoes. Google Nandeyanen for more information on the retort. Okay, I'll do that after stream. That's gonna be interesting. I head down the hall to the cafeteria with Kotomi walking beside me. It's not her usual quick pace. Her stride is quite timid. It feels like she's half filled with hope. The other half is filled with worry. When we get to the store, the lady has just finished lining up the buns. I'm ditching, but she's really smart, so she's exempt from class. She doesn't believe a word I say. Alright, Kotomi, do your greeting. I push Kotomi out from her hiding spot behind me. Not that one, the one we practiced. She faces the lady head on. With a tense expression, she bows. I don't think you need to go that far for a lunch, lady. The lady's eyes widen at Kotomi's excessive greeting. Do you know her? She says it matter-of-factly, but it's news to me. Is that so? While answering me, she turns to Kotomi with a soft smile. I can see the tension melt away as Kotomi's shoulders relax. Alright, I'm a man, so I'll treat you to anything you want, up to 500 yen. I send a signal with my eyes. That's good, Kotomi, just a little quicker and your timing will be perfect. So anyway, go pick the bread you want. なんでやねん? Okay, now you're overreaching. Hey, how about this one? You haven't had this kind before.
初めて見たの。
She looks back and forth between the bun and my face.
ともやくん、好き嫌いある？
At the very least, I'd eat any of the bread here.
そうなんだ。
She picks one of the many types of bread. Seeing that, the bread lady smiles at her.
いただきましょう。
Let's eat. The usual meal begins. The only difference is that Kotomi starts with the bread instead of her lunchbox. She must want to check out what's inside.
はい。ともやくんの分。
Yeah, thanks. I take half of the bread she tore off. This must be peanut frosting.
うん。それにホイップクリームも一緒に入ってるの。
Is it good?
とってもおいしいの。
Her eyes squint as she smiles happily. By the way, about what the bread lady was saying earlier, are your parents college professors or something? She stops chewing and thinks. After a moment, she nods modestly. I see, no wonder you're so smart. She's completely different, even regarding her parents. Then I guess you make your own lunch since your parents are too busy with work? She nods in agreement again. I see, you must have it hard.
もう慣れたから。
She whispers her answer. It seems that she doesn't like to talk about her family. Right when it feels like I should change the subject.
私ね、考えたことがあるの。
About what?
ともやくん、毎日私とお昼ご飯を食べてくれるけど、今のままだときっと先生に怒られると思うの。
They're getting mad at me regardless. Yeah, don't worry. You're not the source of why they're angry with him. I would tease her, but Kotomi is serious about this.
毎日一緒にいてくれるのは本当に嬉しいけど、私はちょっと他の人とは違うから。
That's not something you need to worry about.、うん、
でもね、だから私考えたの。こうやって一緒にお昼を食べるのは毎日じゃいけないなって。ともやくんのお勉強の邪魔したらいけないなって。
You're not in the way of his studies. Like, he himself is in the way of his own studies. I spontaneously fall deep into thought. It's not fun being with me? The moment I ask that, she shakes her head left and right.
そんなことないの。とっても楽しいの。ずっと一緒にいられたらって。
She must be frantic to express something so embarrassing.
でも楽しすぎてなんだか怖いなって思うこともあるの。
To be honest, I don't know what she means. I'm starting to feel that being here is much more fun than my boring classes. Even so, if Kotomi is being considerate of other people, I want to be cooperative. Right now, Kotomi thinks of me as someone special, an irregularity. Unless we change things little by little, Kotomi will continue to think that. Alright. That's what I say. Then how about we eat lunch together? Only on Fridays. But you're still meeting with me after school. Once you make friends, things will be really different for you. Well, that's that. Now I'm gonna eat lots of your cooking. She smiles as if relieved when I start eating. Well, I'll see you after school.
また放課後。
I watch as Kotomi walks off. I better get serious. I'm so full, I feel like I'll pass out this afternoon. Food coma. After school, Kotomi is already waiting at our usual meeting place.
ともやくん、こんにちは。
Sorry, were you waiting long?
うん、私も今来たばかりなの。今日のお友達は誰?
Let's see. I pretend to think, but I'm all out of acquaintances. The only one left is... Sunohara, I guess?
呼んだ?
No, never in a million years.
何お前、女連れ? で、そいつ、一ノ瀬琴美ちゃんよ。
But seriously, I don't know any other normal people.
なんでお前がそんなやつと、って人の話聞いてんのかよ、岡崎。
The only one left is this, the human waste, Sunohara.
Okazaki. Okazaki Tomoya-kun. Oi, kiiteru ka?
What should I do?
Tsuka, boku no koto mieteru yo ne. Koko ni iru tte wakatteru yo ne. Tanomu kara kotaete kure yo. Daichi yuu no Okazaki Tomoya-kun. Kore dake itte mo mushi tsu ka?
He looks really sad. Oh, Sunohara, there you are. God. Besides, I'm not here in the flesh right now. I'm the apparition of Tomoya Okazaki appearing in the dream you're having right now. That's why I'm smarter than you can imagine. It never gets old. Oh my god, Jesus. Indeed. Did you get food poisoning? By the way, Sunohara, what's the capital of Australia?
Australia? それってあれじゃん。ほら、シドニー。
Unfortunately, it's not Sydney, it's Melbourne.
言われてみると、確かにそんなだったような気もする。
I think of Melbourne as two sibling sheep.
確かに。いつものアホアホな岡崎とは違う。
はい。
そうすると、彼女も夢なわけ。
Of course.
なんかありえない生き物を観察するような顔で。僕らのことを見てますけど。
Oh right, I haven't formally introduced you. Now Kotomi, show off your new moves.
こんにちは。はじめまして。3年 A 組の一ノ瀬Kotomiです。趣味は読書です。もしよかったらお友達になってくれると嬉しい。
なあ、岡崎。
What, Sunohara?
僕の聞き違いじゃなければさ、学校一の天才少女が今僕に交際を申し込んできたんですけど。
Of course he would interpret it that way because, I mean, he's Sunohara. Looks like it.
これって夢だよね。
Of course this is just a dream. To prove it, you don't get hurt even if you get punched.
すごく痛いんすけど。
You're dreaming the pain. Back in the real world, you're taking a nap in class.And the teacher's about to catch you and give you hell.
マジっすか?
Yeah, oh, he noticed you're sleeping.
それってマジやべえ状況じゃん! どうすりゃ起きられるんだよ!
Hit your head against the wall over there, you'll eventually wake up.
よし!
Oh my god, no, Sunohara, what the fuck? Let's go, Kotomi.
でも、
He has a condition, don't ask too many questions about it.
そうなんだ。なんだかとっても大変そうなの。
起きろ、傭兵。今すぐ夢から覚めるんだ。早く起きろ、ゴ
ン。Oh my god, no. Leaving the occupied Sunohara behind, I walk away with Kotomi. Oh lord, jeez. I guess we don't have a choice. Let's just call it quits for today. In the end, we don't talk to anyone besides Sunohara. I don't have too many acquaintances. Finding people with free time is really difficult.Kotomi won't get the chance to use her new introduction either. It's too bad, but let's go home. We walk together with heavy steps to the shoe lockers. Fujibayashi's fortune telling came true. I mumbled that while remembering what happened yesterday. If it's exactly as Fujibayashi said, it's because of me. Hey, Koto. The moment I glance at her, a familiar voice comes from behind. I turn around to see Kyo running at me.
なんで逃げんのよ
Kyo tries to stop her.
いじめる?いじめる?いじめる?
ほら、いじめないから。いい子、いい子。
Kyo hugs the teary-eyed Kotomi from behind and rubs her head forcefully. Kotomi goes limp, accepting her cruel fate. She's like a stray cat plucked away while napping at the park.The stress will make the fur in her tail fall out, so knock it off.
え?なにこの子、尻尾があるの?確かめてみちゃおっかな。
うん。
あれ、もっと子供っぽいのつけてるのかと思ったら、案外大人なんだ。
What? She's talking about her panties. Like, did she just check that? What?Like, she can be talking about the uniform, everyone's wearing the same uniform.
うわ、うっそ! こんなにあんの?
I mean, even if they're both girls, this is like not okay. Kyo, turning to women just because guys won't hit on you. Nothing, ma'am. I look away.
一般女子のスキンシップってやつね。友達同士ならこんなの普通普通。
Okay, normal, huh? Wait, what did you say?
スキンシップ?
After that.
友達同士?
You'll be friends with her?
頼まれてってのはごめんだけど、今日は私から来たでしょ?
Okay, but I feel like she was coming on a bit too hard.
あんたの友達ってんなら、間接的に私の友達でもあるし。あと、もう自己紹介もしてるしね。
Still grabbing onto Kotomi, she says that with a smug face. Kotomi looks like she wants to tell me something.
私、尻尾、ないの。
She seems fine for now, so I turn to Kyo.
友達なら遠慮とかってする方が変でしょ?
I guess so. We need to learn more about each other, really?Is that how you learn more about people?
例えば、好きな食べ物とか、好きな遊びとか、好きな服とか。
Okay, I agree with that.
まあ、楽しければ何でもいいんだけど。
She glances at me suggestively.
最初の見せ所だと思わない?
Gosh, she's planning on extorting me.
あ、同じ遊ぶなら人数多い方がいいわよね。そういうわけで、今から寮も連れてくるから、ここでちょっと待っててね。
Wait for her, run away as fast as possible. I don't want to run away. This seems interesting. I want to see how it evolves. I fear for my life, so I decide to wait obediently. Kyo runs off briskly. Without moving an inch, Kotomi and I just look at each other. This is getting out of hand. She says that while touching her skirt near her butt. Okay, I get it. The problem is with Kyo. I better think of something before her next attack. Kotomi and I can't take much more. Having the twins build a friendship outside of school might be too tough for Kotomi. Alright, in that case.
で、ここがあんたの考えてる楽しいところなわけ。
It's a nice place. The drama club room has...A long history, and now's our chance to use it as we see fit. There are lots of mysterious props of all sizes. Right, Kotomi? Kotomi is enthralled by a microphone cable peeking through the gaps in the box. She tries pulling it at it cautiously, as if uprooting some potatoes. she tries wrapping it around herself. She grabs the ends and ties a butterfly knot.
取れなくなってとっても困ったの。
Kyo lets out a huge sigh as Kotomi dangerously plays by herself.
あんたなんかに期待した私がバカだったけどね。
What were you hoping for?
カラオケとかゲーセンとかファミレスとかシネコンとか大きなネズミがいる遊園地とか。
You wanted to go all the way to Tokyo?
何言ってんのよ。もちろんカリフォルニアよ。
I decide to ignore the daydreaming Amazon. Hey, Fujibayashi. I whisper into the younger sister's ear. This is all happening because of your fortune telling.
でもその占いのせいではないと思います。
Your sister is a problem. Doesn't she have a setting to reduce her violent tendencies?
ずっと一緒に暮らしてますけど、見たこと
ない。She took that question so seriously.
それより、勝手に入っていいんでしょうか?
She timidly asks that as she looks around the room. It wasn't locked, so I'm sure it's fine.
だからといって、許可なく入っていいということにはならないと思うんですが。
It's fine. I know the club president. She'll be back soon. I check for Furukawa's bag on the desk while saying that. There she is. I hear a voice at the door. Aside from the preoccupied Kotomi, everyone is focused on the newcomer.
失礼しました。
Wait, club president, it's me. Not knowing where to go, Furukawa is already turning around to leave. I frantically bring her back.
Oh, sumimasen, Okazaki-san deshita ka? Hito ga takusan ite tanoshisou datta node, heya o machigaeta no ka to omoimashita.
You need to be prouder and more affectionate about your own club room.
De, buchou toyou no wa dare no koto deshou ka?
And she doesn't even realize it. You, who else?
Huh?
You started the drama club on your own, right? That means you're the club president.
Yeah, demo sonna watashi nanka de nakutemo.
You started the club, but now you have this many people gathering here. Or are you saying that the drama club still doesn't exist?
Sore wa...
Come on, pull yourself together, club president. After thinking it over.
Wakarimashita. Buchou de ii desu.
She declares it.
Itaranai buchou desu ga, yoroshiku onegai shimasu.
Good. I brought you a bunch of visitors today.
Kengaku kibou desu ka?
Well, it's a long story. With Kyo shooting daggers at me and obviously wanting to say something, I stumble over an answer. That's what Furukawa notices Kotomi. She's still doing battle with the microphone cable in the corner of the room.
Kotomi-chan, konnichiwa desu.
Nagisa-chan.
She manages to escape from her self-inflicted trap and runs over to Furukawa. She places her hands over each other on her skirt and bows.
Konnichiwa. Hajimemashite.
Well, it's not hajimemashite because you've met her before. She bows once more. Looks like she was itching to use her new greeting. Without a second thought, Furukawa considerately accepts why Kotomi said nice to meet you when they had already met.
Konnichiwa, hajimemashite. 3年 B 組の古川渚です。趣味は演劇です。もしよかったらお友達になってくれると嬉しいです。
はい。喜んで。
はい。喜んで。こんにちは。はじめま
して。This is so cute!
3年 D 組の藤林亮です。趣味は占いです。もしよかったらお友達になってくれると嬉しいです。はい、喜んで。
はい、喜んで。
The Kotomi style introduction with the weird mannerism is spreading like a virus.
ほら、お姉ちゃんも自己紹介しないと。
え、私？3年 E 組の藤林京です。
Her hobby is bullying the defenseless.
もしよかったらお友達になってくれると。
って誰の趣味が弱い者いじめよ。
You see that, Kotomi? That's the miraculous standing start, drop kick retort.
私本当はとっても強いからいじめないでほしいの。
I'm done with you.
ほな、さいなら。
パチパチパチパチパチパチ。
One hour later, the room has taken on a relaxed atmosphere.
Nagisa-chan, これ何？
多分昔演劇部で使っていた小道具だと思うんですが、魔法のバトンのように見えますけど。
The three seem to have opened up to each other. They're playing with the drama club props.
魔法のバトンって何？
振りながら呪文を唱えると。星がパーッと散って、妖精が現れて。
Fujibayashi tries her best to explain.
呪文ってどういうものなんでしょう？
私、古本で読んだことあるの。
あ、私、そういうのすごく興味あるから、唱えるところを見てみたいです。
それじゃあ、やってみるの。
ことみちゃん、はい。バトンです。
ありがとうなの。ティビマグヌムイノミナンドゥームシグナステラルムニグラルムエブファニフォルミスサドクエシジルム。
おお、何も起こらないみたい。
あれれ、もしかしたらちょっと発音が悪かったのかもしれないの。
でも琴美ちゃんすごいです。私もそんな風にスラスラとセリフを言えるようになりたいです。
それにすごく本格的な呪文だったからかっこよかったです。
じゃあもう一度唱えてみるの。
はい、頑張ってください。
ティビマグヌムイノミナンドゥーム。
I don't know what's going on, but they seem to be having fun. Right beside me is Kyo, relaxing in a chair with nothing to do. You should join in.
私にバトン持って変な呪文を唱えろっての？そんな図想像できる？
Well, I can try. The sight of Kyo waving a wand and casting a spell. I'm sorry.
まあ、友達ってのもいろんなタイプがいるわけだし、琴美みたいなタイプもありだけどさ。とりあえず共通の話題とかがあれば楽なんだけど、琴美って趣味の幅ちょっと狭そうよね。
Hey, I don't know about that.Kotomi, come here for a second. What's that?
魔法のバトンなの。
We don't need props here. Put it back where you found it. She nods and does as I ask.
置いてきたの。
Alright, Kotomi. We'll show everyone what you're really capable of. What's the capital of the United States of America?
ニューヨークと見せかけてワシントン DC。
What's the scientific name for boars?
ススクロファレウコミュスタクス。
Whew, that's a name. The kanji for amberjack is fish and...
Si.
What's the height of Kyoto Tower?
131 meters. 展望室は地上100 meters.
Amazing, right? Everyone needs a Kotomi in their home. You'll have a treasure trove of useless trivia. Order this smoking hot deal right now and she'll come with her own special charger and an extra set of batteries.
うちは間に合ってます。
Don't feel down, Kotomi. The world is a big place. I'm sure there are some houses that'll need you.
本当に本当?
No, there might be one house that might have a need for you if you're lucky.
いじめっこ。
I was about to say, that's kind of bullying. Don't sulk about it. The world is a cruel place. Kotomi Mark 1, the all-purpose appliance robot, nods in earnest. Alright, let's move on to the next place to try selling.
お姉ちゃん、かわいそうだから置いてあげようよ。
ダメだったらダメ。わけわかんない学名とか、魚へんにどうとか、うさんくさい塔の高さとか言えたって、実生活では一円の得にもなんないでしょ。
だって…
The kind but not so smart younger sister and the ruthlessly realistic older sister.
情が移らないうちに元いた場所に置いてきなさい。ほら。
そんな。
You're adding abandoned cat into her character features.
私は何の役をすればいいんでしょう。
You're playing the role of the evil drama club president who's trying to steal the weird all-purpose robot from the poor twins.
誰が貧乏な双子姉妹よ。
I like Kyo's no-nonsense approach to life. Yeah, I can appreciate that. It's just, like I said, I'm more like, more like Ryo myself than Kyo. By the way, you're playing the mean older sister. Correction, the beautiful and kind older sister. Nagisa just rolls with it. A new character appears out of nowhere.
の役だと難しすぎて。
Then what role can you play?
普通の演劇部長の役ならできそうです。
You get to properly compare the sisters doing Kyo's routine. Okay, we'll see. It's actually the next one on the list after we finish Kotomi, so looking forward to that. She finally realizes it and stands right next to Furukawa. Her ultimate backhand chop explodes.
Kimi, その mamaya ga na.
As you can see, she also has a high-speed retort function installed. Oh yeah, your retort speed is a million times faster. Kyo is on a roll. Seeing the overwhelming difference in specs, Kotomi continues to feel down. difference in specs, oh my god.
でもね、私は大丈夫。たくさんたくさん練習して、いつかは立派な夫婦漫才師になるの。
Who are you going to make your partner?
ことみちゃん偉いです。すごく頑張り屋さんです。
And you, don't get emotional over all of this.
私、応援しますから、頑張ってくださいね。
Thank you, so pure.
あの、私も応援させてください。頑張りましょう。三人で力を合わせて。
Furukawa, Fujibayashi, and Kotomi get together and make a promise with each other. The role of the idiot fits them all better. So I doubt I'll see any progress.By the time we leave the building, it's already getting dark out. The five of us had been in the drama club room until the school closed. On the slope in front of the school gates, the girls are walking together in a circle with Kotomi in the middle. I'm lagging a short distance behind. For some reason, I'm carrying five bags. Kyo said a man should be able to carry this easily. Now I'm carrying everyone's school bags. Kotomi had intended to carry her own, but the situation kind of forced her into making me carry it.
この坂がさ、鬱陶しいのよね、毎朝毎朝。
でも、お花見の季節にはとても綺麗です。
お花見ね。
You never look at the flowers anyway because you're too busy eating.
うっさいわね。
それなら、明日はみんなで一緒にお昼を食べませんか？
あ、それいいかもです。
何がそれならなのかがちょっと引っかかるけど。
そんなこと言わないで、お姉ちゃんも一緒に食べよう。
ま、あたしも暇だからいいけどね。
よかったら、琴美ちゃんもどうですか？
私？
You don't need to check with me.
うん。私もみんなと一緒にお昼食べたいの。
They start discussing plans with enjoyment. They can make friends really easily, huh?
あんたは何にやけてんのよ。
Leave me alone.
そっか。両手に花いっぱいだもんね。
Look carefully. The only things I'm surrounded by are your bags.
情緒がないわね。この場合の花っていうのは。可愛い女の子のこと。
One of them is covered in sharp thorns.
なんか言った？
Must have been your imagination.
岡崎さんもどうですか？明日のお昼なんですが。
I mean, I gotta say, the interactions between Toboya and Kyo are like golden. They're really, really fun. So, I ain't complaining about that. Well...I might want to join in too.
明日も両手に花いっぱいね。
Not gonna touch that one. I hand the bags back at the bottom of the slope. They take that as a signal to tell each other the ways they go home.
私はあっちだから。
あ、私は 今日はここからバスなので。
What? Don't they live in the same place?
一緒に帰らないんですか？この子はバスだけど、私は違うから。
渚ちゃんはどっちですか？
はい、向こうの道から帰ります。
I'm going this way. I pull at Kotomi's sleeve since she's standing still. She seems to wake up from a dream as she turns to me. Why are you so out of it? Come on, say your phrase to everyone.
こんにちは。
No!
はじめまして。
No, that's the wrong one. This is the time to say bye to everyone.
そっか。でも、まだ練習してないの。
Just do the usual. While holding her bag, she adjusts the hem of her skirt. She then bows once to each person she met today.
Nagisa-chan, また明日。
はい、また明日です。
Ryo-chan, また明日。
また明日。
私は？
Kyo-chan, また明
日。うん、また明日ね。
Thanks, see you later. I say that and turn around to leave.
あんたんちってそっちだっけ?
I'm going to walk her back part of the way.
Hmm.
What's with that hmm? Huh?
Okazaki-kun mo, sayonara desu.
Yeah, see ya. After I give that half-hearted response, the Fujibayashi sisters go off in separate directions.
それでは私も失礼します。
Furukawa says that and walks away with steady strides. The day was a bit tiring.
でもね、とっても楽しかったの。
Oh yeah? That's good. She still seems excited about what happened today. Tomorrow might be even more fun.
明日?
She must be thinking about tomorrow's lunch already. She's absent-minded the entire way back.
お弁当…いつもよりたくさん作らないと。
Don't make too much. They're going to bring their own, too.
わかったの。でも、やっぱりちょっと多めにしちゃうかも。
Well, with me and Kyo there, I'm sure we'll be able to finish it off. We soon arrive at the usual street corner. Kotomi stands still and lets out a big sigh. Then she says the last goodbye of the night.
Tomoya-kun.また明日。
Kotomi gives me a big smile. Yeah, see you tomorrow. She returns to her usual quick pace as she walks away. I see her off until she disappears completely from my view under the evening sky. The day was too tiring, but it didn't feel half bad. I head home too. The phantom weight of the bag still lingers on my arms. Fujibayashi's fortune failed to come true in spectacular fashion. That's cute. Ah. School's out. After homeroom ends, I race out of the classroom. The bread store isn't as packed on Saturdays as it is on weekdays, but the good ones always sell out quickly. I jump down the stairs and turn a corner into the hallway. Because I got a late start, there's already a crowd. I notice Furukawa wandering back and forth carrying her wallet, blocked off by the crowd. You're buying bread too?
はい、いつもの通りです。
It's really crowded, huh?
さっきから、なんとかパンに近づこうとしてるんですが。
Alright, I'll back you up while you go in to buy something. I hand her my wallet and Furukawa nods in agreement with a serious face.
わかりました。やってみます。岡崎さんは、どんなパンがいいですか?
Surprise me. As I say that, I remember Kotomi. If possible, could you get one that's sweet and interesting?
面白そうなパンですか?
Like, the whole thing is a roll, or the kind that's divided up into multiple sections, or one that has a really complicated structure.
探してみます。
Alright, now go!
はい。
The two of us walk upstairs with the full bag. In the bag is oolong tea for each person and a mountain of dessert bread.
ちょっと買いすぎてしまいました。
Furukawa has done well. We have lots of people, so it should be fine. It's been a while since I've walked with Furukawa like this. We feel the presence of people already in the drama club room.
Osoi!
The moment we enter the room, we hear a familiar voice yelling at us. Fujibayashi and Kotomi are sitting in chairs, waiting. You're just too early. Hey, hold on. What's that? That's all I can say upon seeing what's on the table. did she prepare a big feast? Yeah, I can tell just by looking at it. The table is covered with the multi-layered boxes used for New Year's feasts. The contents of the boxes are exactly those of New Year's feasts.
エビはヒゲがあって腰が曲がっているから長寿祈願の象徴なの。ニシンの昆布巻きは蓋親が喜ぶというダジャレなの。
She hits people with her outdated trivia when it's least expected.
黒豆は豆々しく働くようになの。これが本当の豆知識なの。
This traditional Japanese wordplay has been repeated millions of times at New Year's parties all over Japan. Setting that aside, New Year's feasts are meant to be eaten over a few days with family members. It's impossible to finish everything here. Kotomi, you know, she probably got too excited thinking about the menu yesterday and simply went overboard. The only happy thing is in your hand.
いいじゃない。私も気持ちはよくわかるし。 これだけのもの作ってもらえたら男冥利に尽きるってもんでしょ。
She says it like it has nothing to do with her.
ちょっとだけ量を間違えちゃったんだよね。そうなの。
Just a little bit. Accidentally made a feast instead of just a lunch. It's also the wrong season, like by about 4 months.
なんだかお正月みたいですごく楽しそうです。
Yeah, Nagisa's on board.
それに
美味しそう。とっても、おめでとう。ことみちゃん、おめでとう。私からもおめでとうございます。 Getting lively, but this one section is celebrating the new year. I placed a bag full of oolong tea and bread on top of the table. Well, the food isn't going to eat itself, let's get started. This is the first I've heard about it. Traitor. Furukawa sits down after being brought over by Kyo. They seem to have their roles reversed, but it doesn't feel unnatural. There's something wrong with this picture. Kotomi stands up straight and passes out festive chopsticks in paper wrappers. I hope this year will be great for everyone in more ways than one. Come on, there's still a lot. You definitely gained 3 kilograms in the last hour. In the end, only Kyo's and Fujibayashi's lunchboxes are empty. A lot of the New Year's feast and bread still remain. Keep at it, Furukawa. You have to fight, Fujibayashi. Kotomi. But they both paid the same. Everyone's in trouble due to eating too much. Yes, please. Kotomi sluggishly rises and unscrews the cap of the thermos. The liquid gives off steam and fragrance as it's poured into paper cups. The five of us sip the tea.
ねえ、腹ごなしに何か娯楽になるようなものはないの、部長？
どういうものがいいでしょう？
テーブルでできるゲームみたいなやつ。
She looks around the room.
魔法のバトンならあります。備品ですけど。
で、それのどこがテーブルでできるゲームよ。
すみません。
Fujibayashi, don't you have playing cards?
はい、持ってます。
She takes them out of her uniform pocket. She fumbles as she shuffles the cards.
何を占いましょうか?
We're not doing that. Can we borrow them to play games with?
何やる?
Kyo suddenly joins in.
私、トランプはあんまりやったことないですけど。
Just tell me what you do know how to play.
神経衰弱とか。
Let's not play stuff that relies on memory. I suspect someone here has a huge unfair advantage in that department, so I suggest against that. Let's just play poker. Everyone here knows the rules, right?
はい。多分わかると思います。
ポーカーには、主としてホールデムとスタッドポーカーと
There she goes with the trivia.
細
かいルールなんて適当でいいのよ。よ、貸して。
She snatches the cards away, divides them into two stacks, and deftly shuffles them. Everyone gets their five cards in the blink of an eye.
ねえ、何かける?
That's way too sudden.
テーブルの上におせち料理とトランプ。あと足りないのはこたつとみかんぐらいね。
She grabs some of the remaining sweet potatoes with chestnuts and tosses them in her mouth. You're amazing.
甘いものは別腹なの。
Oh, I'll change one.
I have 2 枚。私は1枚お願いします。
はいはいはい。
Kyo deals the cards like a professional.
それで私が1枚チェンジっと。これはまたもらっちゃったかも。
すみません。私おります。私も。
Kotomi has already folded. Why do you three give up so fast?
お姉ちゃんと岡崎くんを見てるだけでも楽しいですから。
Furukawa is nodding in agreement.
そういうあんたは本当にいいの?後悔しても知らないわよ。
I can't back down now.
それじゃあ、あと10 days ね。
Hmm.
ほらほら、降りるなら今よ。
Call.
ああ。
Shut up, come on, show your hand. Three jacks.
Atashi buta.
What in the hell, nothing?
Onee-chan, buta datta nda. Buta nano ni anna ni tsuri-ageru nante, sugoi desu.
Kyo-chan, honto ni buta?
That's right, she's the only one who can bluff her way through without a real hand. While the audience is showering her with praise, Kyo reaches for the sweet potatoes with chestnuts.She notices something and freezes.
Nanio? Minna, eat I could go on, or Hakiri, eat us, are you?
Oh, Nejan, Otsuite. Kotomi-changa, Genki, Nai, Mitai, Nandesuga.
Hm? She's right, Kotomi has been withdrawn for a while.
Onaka demo, itaino?
Chigau no. Ne.
With everyone watching, she explains.
今日、返さないといけない古本があるの。
なんだ、帰りがけに返却ポストに入れてけばいいじゃない。
図書室じゃなくて、県立図書館の古本なの。
え?あそこって結構遠いじゃない。
今日は土曜日だから、今から電車でもギリギリかも。
一日ぐらい遅れたっていいでしょ?
Fujibayashi and Kyo try to convince her, but Kotomi continues to shake her head in disagreement.
次の人が待ってるかもしれないの。読みたい古本が読めないのは、とってもとっても悲しいことなの。
それ、私もわかる気がします。うん。
それならそうと、最初から言っとけば。
Kotomi just hangs her head. She looks like a small girl being disciplined for a prank she pulled. Kyo stands up while scratching her head.
いいから早く行きなさいって。
うん。でも私全然片付けてないし。
Looking at the messy table, Kotomi is still hesitant.
そう思うならパン持ってきなさい。片付かないから。
Kyo takes Kotomi's bag without permission and starts stuffing it with bread. What are you, some pushy aunt?
あの、Kotomi-chan の重箱は私が持って帰って洗っておきますから。
You can leave them in here so she can pick them up whenever.
はい、演劇部室は開けておきますし、それに放課後はきっと私がいますから。
She smiles at Kotomi, further encouraging her. Kotomi seems to have made up her mind.
それじゃあ私、先に帰るから、重箱とお片付け、お願いするの。
はいはい、任せなさい。それよりいい？自分の都合が悪い時には無理して付き合わなくていいから。今日じゃなくてもいつだって会えるでしょ。私たちは逃げも隠れもしないから。
No, that's so nice. You sound threatening. No, she didn't mean that way.
それじゃね、琴美ちゃん。またお昼食べよ。今度は私もお弁当作ってきますから。
She takes her bag stuffed with books and dessert buns.
みんな、とってもごめんなさい。それで、とってもありがとう。
She bows deeper than usual. All right, let's hurry, Kotomi. We run out together.
ちょっと待った。
What?
あんたは戻ってくること。
Why?
まだ全部食べてないでしょ?
You're heartless. You sure we should part here? I'll walk you to the station.
ここでいいの。今日は私の分まで、みんなと一緒にいてくれると嬉しいの。
All right. Her hair is slightly tussled from all the running. I place my hand on top of her head. She looks up at me and smiles innocently, like a child. She must be absorbing everything at amazing pace to make up for the time lost when she didn't have friends.It makes me feel happy, but lonely at the same time. It's a weird feeling.
Tomoya-kun, mata ashita, janakute, Tomoya-kun, mata raishu.
Yeah, see you next week. She turns around while carrying her heavy bag and starts running. Don't trip and fall, be careful, alright? She soon disappears from view. Now then, I rub my still engorged stomach. I better head back to the feast from hell. I start climbing the long, long slope back to school. By the time I wake up, it's already past noon. I'd usually force myself to get up, but I don't feel like it today. I stare at the ceiling and think about yesterday. I think I went overboard. I think the days will be even more exhausting starting tomorrow. I better get enough sleep while I can.I roll back over and close my eyes again. All the while, I'm thinking about how long it's been since I've stayed home all day. After school, I grab my empty bag and exit the classroom. Now then, I'd usually be meeting up with Kotomi, but we didn't make plans to see each other because of the commotion on Saturday. I should check out the drama club room. She might be talking with Furukawa or someone while picking up her lunchboxes.I go up the stairs and arrive on the third floor. The clubs may be off because we're between holidays. It's quieter than usual. But Furukawa will probably still be there. I open the sliding door to the drama club as usual.
Tomoya-kun じゃありませんか?
How do I respond to that?
面白くなかった?
You don't have to take it so hard.
ほら見なさい。あんたのギャグは古すぎるわ。おまけにタイミングも悪いし、振りに勢いもない。芸人として致命的ね。わかったらそっちの隅で素振りでもしてなさい。
なんでやねん。なんでやねん。 なんでやねん。
Kotomi practices her backhand chop with a serious face. I have no idea what's going on. So, what were you talking about before I got here?
将来の夢とかいろいろ話し合ってたのよ。
How did that turn into a skit taking place at comedian school? At a comedian school?
こっちが聞きたいわよ。
Kyo says that glumly. She must have been sucked into the Kotomi dimension before she knew it. Sorry, I don't get it either.
いいけど、ちゃんと教育しといてよね。あんたがご主人様なんだから。
Yeah, I'll be careful. Wait, who are you calling a handler?
なんでやねん。なんでやねん。なんでやねん。
いいのよ、照れなくても。あんたがいない間にいろいろ聞いたんだから。ある。
Don't ask about untrue stuff.
なんでやねん。なんでやねん。なんで。
なあもう気が散るからもっと静かに練習して。
The trainee focuses entirely on her swing, just as the strict instructor told her. A journey of 1,000 miles starts with a single step. Good luck. Anyway, the others aren't here yet?
そうみたいね。
That means they were alone until I dropped in. Setting aside their discussion, considering how Kotomi didn't run away, they're probably getting along quite well. I hear footsteps in the hallway. Looks like someone's here.
Kotomi-chan, imasu ka?
Kotomi stops her swinging and jumps to the door as if she had been waiting for it.
Ryo-chan ja.
Yokatta. Sumimasen. Jūbako o aratte kita n desu kedo, sono...持ってくるのが遅くなって。
りょうちゃんじゃ、
もう帰っちゃってたらどうしようかと思いました。
はい、
これ。
Kotomi still tries to insert her line. She hands over the layered lunch boxes in a plastic bag.
多分綺麗になってると思いますから。
りょうちゃんじゃ、ありがとうなの。
Your joke is getting weird.
遅くなってすみません。
The club president enters the room in a rather undignified way. This is your chance to make up for the past screw-ups, Kotomi Ichinose.
渚ちゃんじゃありませんか。
Kotomi ちゃんじゃありませんか。
There she is! I love how she just rolls with the situation. That was a great attack, evil drama club president.Yes, super cute.
君たちがいて、僕がいる。いずこへ、アークサ。
These one-liners are all out of order.
むちゃくちゃでごじゃりまするがな。
Our relaxing time together begins.
ご本なら、何でも大好きなの。
私は占いの本とかかな。私も演劇関係のことをもっと勉強しなければと思ってるんですけど。
I sit in a chair by the window and watch as the three of them laugh. They look like they've been friends forever. I think summer is on the way.
ていうか、あんたは何やってんのよ。
As you can see, I'm enjoying this elegant afternoon.
気が利かないわね。
What's that supposed to mean?
自分だけ楽しんでないで、ここにいる全員が幸せになれるようにしなさいってこと。
Tell me specifically how I'm supposed to do that.
具体的には、私はフルーツ牛乳。ほら、あんたたちも好きなの頼みなさい。
Fine. The moment I said that, Kyo looks surprised.
本当におごってくれるわけ?
It's okay once in a while. I stretch out my arm and stand up from the chair.I get 5 juice boxes and carry them back to the, down the hallway. If Sunohara sees me, I know he'll give me crap for this. After thinking about it, I'm actually surprised to find that I don't mind doing this. I feel like I was more on edge when I first started third year. That must mean I've changed. Furukawa, Kyo, Fujibayashi, and Kotomi. It's only the third day since that group started meeting in the drama club room. Aside from Furukawa, none of the others are even drama club members.An outside observer wouldn't have any idea what kind of group this is. things always change like that, I think. Rather than wait for things to change on their own, you have to take matters into your own hands. Otherwise, things will never change for the better. As I approach the drama club, I hear a noise. A ticklish yet familiar noise. A violin? I stop and listen. I don't hear anything. Maybe it was my imagination. Whoa. The door opens on its own.
Okazaki-kun, okaeri nasai.
It's just Fujibayashi opening the door.
Osoi.
Don't say that, I came straight back. What am I, some kid lost while running an errand? Everyone stops talking and listens to the sound coming from beyond the open door. No, it sounds like it's coming from another club room. I heard a noise earlier, but now I can hear an actual tune. It sounds like a piece from a famous classical tune. The melody flows smoothly. Beats me. I notice that Kosumi is acting strangely. She's completely motionless and concentrating on the faraway sound. Kotomi? She suddenly stands up and darts off like a rabbit. like a rabbit, I can just imagine it. I run after the hypnotized Kotomi. The sound of the violin is coming from inside the club room. Kotomi opens the door without hesitation and heads in. I have no choice but to follow her. I glance up and find the plate that reads Choral Club above the door. It must have been founded recently since the inside doesn't look much different from a regular classroom. A second year girl is standing in the middle of the room. She's staring at Kotomi while holding her violin. There are two other second year girls in the room for a total of three.
あれれ?
Kotomi turns to me looking bewitched. It seems like she doesn't know why she ran all the way here. The second year holding the violin cautiously opens her mouth. You're asking for too much and stop using that comedian's jokes. Kyo arrives late. Behind her are Fujibayashi and Furukawa, craning their necks to see inside. Kyo quickly tries to ease the situation. She smiles bashfully. The other choral club members are still nervous. I don't blame them. A bunch of random third years just barged into their club. And the cause of all the commotion...
Violin.
She points at it like a child. Yeah, it's a violin.
でも合唱部ってバイオリンなんて使うんだ。いえ、そうじゃないんです。この場合は音楽室に置きっぱなしにされていたそうなんです。卒業した音楽部員が置いていったらしいんですが、それで音楽部の知り合いから価値のあるものなのか調べてほしいって言われたんです。うーん、詳しいんだそういうの。それほどでもないですけど、
I knew you'd ask. Now that she mentions it, I notice that the violin is covered in dust and discolored in more than a few spots. While she's talking, Kotomi continues to stare fixedly at the violin. Her sense of curiosity is stronger than most people's, but I've never seen her so interested in something. You've never seen a violin before? She holds the violin out to Kotomi. It's not something you can play right off the bat, though. Why are you giving me three question marks with your blank face? She's looking to me for some reason. she whispers to me.
私も弾けるから。
それならぜひどうぞ。
Kotomi, あんたに言ってんのよ。ほら。
I grab Kotomi's head and turn it to face the violin.
いいから貸してもらいなさいよ。弾いてみたいって顔に書いてあるわよ。
She frantically starts rubbing her cheeks. She might look stupid at first glance, but she's actually making a really complicated joke. I explain for her. She takes the violin with her left hand and cautiously positions the chin rest as if handling glass. Aww. She holds up the bow.
なかなか様になってるじゃない。
Despite what Kyo said, Kotomi is too nervous to respond. We watch her and can feel her nervousness and hesitation. The fingers of her right hand clutching the bow are quivering in short bursts. Take a deep breath. She inhales deeply and holds it for a second. The bow delicately touches the strings. that doesn't sound good. A timbre difficult to describe resonates through the entire room. Oh god, it's so hard to read. This is music to no one's ears. It feels like all the gods in the heavens are holding a concert, but the instruments never arrived. Oh, my eyes hurt. And they're all taking a saw to a chalkboard out of spite. Well, that's descriptive. It's a gruesome otherworldly screeching. She's not listening. Suddenly the noise stops.
声に出してうっとりしてる。
今度はちゃんと曲を弾いてみるの。
っていうかあんた、ちゃんとって意味ちゃんとわかってる？
ことみちゃん、ことみちゃん、慣れるまでもうちょっと小さな音で。
ああ、ダメです。もう間に合いません。
The second wave is coming. Everyone brace yourselves.The choral club room is in chaos. Everyone plugs their ears so hard that it feels like we'll crush our skulls. Aww. Oh my goodness. The torture masquerading as a recital ends. The reverberations of the roaring noise disappear and serenity returns to the room. I cautiously take my hands off my ears.
まだ耳がキーンってなってます。私も。
殺人オーパー？
こんなの私の知ってるバイオリンと違う。
In the middle of it all, Kotomi looks ecstatic.
うっとり。
うわ、またうっとりしてる。
今度はもっと長い曲に挑戦なの。
God, stop it! It's finally over. She takes her chin off the violin and sighs in satisfaction.
とてもとっても楽しかったの。ご清聴ありがとうございました。
She curtsies as if finishing a concert.
あれれ?
She looks at the pile of corpses that is her audience and tilts her head in confusion.
みんな寝てるの?
Yes, you are Jigglypuff and sang them all to sleep. We're dead. Confirming that peace has returned, everyone gets up. The original inhabitants of the room, the victims of the flames of war, are glaring at us. Sorry. I know it isn't my fault, but I apologize anyway. The person who had lent the violin doesn't know how to react. I don't think that's the problem. I think we have to switch out the performer for sure.
Nagisa-chan, 大丈夫? 大丈夫です。
私のバイオリン、どうだった?
Oh my god.
なんていうか、
すごく不思議な音でした。ガラスをひっかく音と黒板をひっかく音とフォークで食器をひっかく音が程よく混ざっていたような気がします。
I mean, she's not lying. She's saying it in a very sweet way. It's a destructive psychological weapon.
褒めてくれてありがとう。誰も褒めとりゃせんわ。
Kyo Fujibayashi revives and shouts that out. But Kotomi is so happy she doesn't hear it. She touches the body of the violin as if to feel the warmth of the wood. It's like she's been reunited with a friend from a long time ago. Are you sure you learned how to play the violin? She's hesitating again.
ずっとちっちゃい頃にちょっとだけ。
やっぱり姿勢とかきちんとしてましたから。レッスン好きでした？
She nods in response to the question.
いいな。私は大嫌いだったかも。
She jokingly smiles as she says that.
どうもありがとう。とっても楽しかったの。
Well, at least she had fun. Kotomi neatly holds out the violin and bows. After taking it back, she returns the violin to a case sitting open on the podium. And then returns to Kotomi.
よかったら何日か使ってみませんか？音楽部の方には私から説明しておきますから。
Is it so she doesn't come back? Is she giving her the violin so she doesn't come back?
この子ずっと放っておかれてましたけど、きっと誰かが弾いてくれるのを待っていたんだと思います。少しの間でももう一度音を奏でたいって思ってます。きっと。
She says that as she slowly closes the case. I can tell how much she likes violins from the way she moves her hands. She holds out the violin case to Kotomi as if bestowing a magic sword upon her.
どうぞ。
Stepping into a meeting for a while, probably not be able to message when stream ends, so big that's me. Aww, that's so cute of you, Squid. Thank you so much. Good luck with the meeting. Hope it's not too long and boring. And Kotomi timidly holds out both hands and accepts it.
Arigato.
Yeah, thank you. Have a great rest of your day too. She looks down at the aged case and then looks up again.
Arigato.
She smiles happily as if the best thing in the world has happened to her. After returning to the drama club room, Kotomi starts doing maintenance on the violin. Using a piece of cloth Furukawa gave her, she wipes down the violin's exterior. Looking at it more closely, it really is beat up.
とっても素敵なバイオリンなの。
She says that with a straight face, without stopping her hands. Kotomi will borrow the violin until lunchtime on Friday. She was told that she can take it and play it wherever she wants. It's a proper violin for beginners. Considering that the previous owner left it behind, it probably isn't worth much. After Kotomi returns it, it will probably never be played again. I stare at Kotomi's fingers moving happily while thinking that.
とりあえず、今日はもう弾かないわけね。
うん。はあ、よかった。
Oh. Don't make your relief so obvious.
これでよしと。
After cleaning the violin, Kotomi turns to the bow.
あった。
She takes something out of the violin case. It's a round, amber-colored thing that's smaller than her palm.
それ何ですか？
松ヤニなの。これを弓毛に塗らないと、きちんと音が鳴らないの。
綺麗。透き通ってる。すごく高級な石鹸みたいです。
With the chunk of rosin in her hand, she slides it across the bow. It makes me realize that what a delicate instrument it is.
渚ちゃん、あのね。
はい、何でしょう。
このバイオリンね、金曜日までこの部屋に置いておいていい？
Why? You can take it home and practice as much as you want.
あんた、近所迷惑って言葉知ってる？
I know that phrase doesn't exist in your dictionary.
手加減って言葉もないけど。
Please learn both right now or else my life will be in danger.
家ではあんまり弾きたくないから。
それなら、ここで弾くといいです。
部長、あんた正気で言ってんの？
はい、琴美ちゃんのバイオリンはなんだか懐かしい音がしました。
Her technique is the same as an infant, so maybe that's why you thought it felt similar.
それだけではないです。
She unexpectedly says it outright.
さっきのはいきなりだったのでびっくりしてしまいましたけど、心の準備ができていれば大丈夫だと思います。
You really can't call what happened earlier listening to music.
でもね。
Kyo is about to say something but is interrupted by Fujibayashi.
その、私もそう思います。さっきの琴美ちゃん、すごく嬉しそうでしたから、きっと子供の頃、バイオリンを弾くのが大好きだったんだなって思いました。だから、その頃の通りに、弾いてほしいです。
Kotomi stops moving her hands and looks at the two of them.
Akisa ちゃん、りょうちゃん。
I like them, they get her.
私ね、頑張るから、たくさん、たくさん練習するから。
はい、練習すればきっと、もっともっと上手に弾けるようになります。私も応援するから、三人で頑張ろうね。
アキサちゃん、リョウちゃん、とってもとってもありがとう。
The three girls further strengthen their friendship through the old violin. It's a touching sight to behold. If only I hadn't heard that monstrosity of a tune earlier.
ああもう。
Kyo and I look at each other.
今度から耳栓持ってくることにするわ。
Considering how that's not stopping you from coming, you're a huge softie. When I say that, she gives me a huge smug grin.
あんたには負けるけどね。
I wake up late this morning. I'm still thinking about the dream I had. Then I fall back asleep. This is the greatest luxury in my life.Afternoon. I finish eating and consider what to do. Yesterday was hectic, so I want to relax a bit today. Thinking back, I can't help but smile wryly. I didn't expect to ever think about relaxing at home. I wonder what they're doing. I start thinking about the people who gather at the drama club room. It's nice outside today. It might be nice to wander around instead of running from something for a change. Stay at home, go outside. Okay.We're gonna go outside, don't be a lazy bum completely, Tomoya. I decide to go outside. I rise from the bed and get dressed. I spend this holiday looking around town. Aside from there being more people than usual, not much else is different. I wander around aimlessly, not looking for anything in particular. It takes a lot to get myself out there, but I always end up doing the same things. Walking around without any particular purpose, I suddenly feel nervous.It's too much trouble to go to Sunohara's place. I'll just go to school. Mumbling that, I smirk to myself. I wouldn't expect to hear that from someone who's perpetually late and truant. Despite that, my legs carry me somewhere I don't really want to go. The school is surprisingly crowded for a holiday. The chatting students seem more cheery than during regular weekdays. It's probably because they're more relaxed.When I enter the front field, I pass by club members running laps. I hear cries from the other fields that sound like the soccer team and baseball team competing against each other. All this effort on a day off. Just a short time ago, I would have resented them. Since club members are here, the school building should be open too. I head to the shoe lockers. The inside of the building is as expected, empty. It may be different in the hall with all the club rooms.I subconsciously start heading to the drama club room, but I stop myself. Somewhere outside the window, I hear all sorts of sounds. It sounds like the concert band tuning up, a cacophony of noise from brass instruments. These sounds mix with cheers from the field. From the gym, I hear bamboo swords smacking against each other and the heavy sounds of bouncing balls. One strange sound is interwoven among all the others. It sounds like a saw cutting wood. I listen carefully, trying to pinpoint the origin of the sound. Is that... I start walking again. After climbing up the stairs of the old building, my supposition is confirmed. I can hear a noise resembling a hacksaw up ahead. That means it's coming from the library. There's only one person who would use a saw, I mean a violin, inside the library. As usual, the placard reads close. Also as usual, the crooked sliding door is slightly ajar. Seeing that, I feel a slight sense of relief. I peer through the opening. Kotomi is in there. Like always, she's in her uniform while standing barefoot in front of the display shelf. The only difference is that she's holding a violin instead of a book. Scree, scree, scree! She's playing a short melody over and over and over again. I guess practice tunes are all like that. The sound itself is as horrible as before, but she seems to be playing with more care than yesterday. She plays the same melody in a different pitch. I don't know too much about it, but this must be how beginners practice. She wipes the sweat off her forehead, her chin remaining on the violin's chin rest. She then places the bow back on the strings. I'd better not bother her. Right when I'm about to move away from the door, she stops playing. I frantically push myself against the wall. After a few seconds of silence, I start to hear the noise again. Her concentration must be faltering since her performance seems a little clumsier. I tiptoe away from the library. I descend the slope alone. Until a few weeks ago, the trees were full of peach-colored petals. I look up to find the green tunnel that's terrible on the eyes. Beyond that is the unchanging blue sky of late afternoon. I didn't have anything. A realization comes to me suddenly. I didn't have anything to motivate me, and I couldn't find anything new. After my father became like that, I didn't want to go anywhere near my house. Everything just seemed like a huge pain in the ass. I'm the only one who's special. The rest of the world is boring. I felt as if taking that attitude absolved me. But now I have a goal. I want to hear Kotomi play her violin. That's not a bad goal. I whispered that out loud to nobody in particular. It's morning. I climb up the slope. The first class hasn't even started yet. I feel like grabbing someone and explaining how awesome I am for actually being here right now. But this is just the beginning. I have a goal I want to achieve. I will be in class all day today. To put it in Kotomi speak, I have to be in class for all subjects. Honestly, I just realized that I'm getting dangerously low on my attendance quota. This week is sandwiched by holidays, so it's a 3-day week. Now's the time to do something I'm not used to. The first bell rings. Alright, let's do this. I psych myself up for no reason and walk through the school gates. Classes are over and homeroom is letting out. Everyone in the classroom starts preparing for after-school activities. At that moment, my lifeless body sinks into the chair. I won. I succeeded in not falling asleep in any of the classes. It's a marvelous feat, a miracle if you will. All I needed to do was actually pay attention during class. Still, I'm so sleepy. If I visit the drama club room, there's a slight high chance I'll be dragged into Kotomi's practicing with the violin. I should take a quick nap. I put my head down on my desk and close my eyes.
Tomoya-kun.
Aww. I hear a voice.
Tomoya-kun. Tomoya-kun. Tomoya-kun.
Someone is repeating my name. This is...
Tori. Tomoya-kun, konnichiwa.
Don't hello me.
Gokigenyou.
She asks me that with a straight face while holding her violin. It's like she hasn't changed at all. In more ways than one. You know, I was enjoying my little nap. I almost fell into an eternal sleep from the shock.
岡崎、なんなんだよそいつ。お前の知り合いかよ。いきなり変な音出しやがって。
The students still in the classroom start pressing me for answers. I don't know anything. I don't know her.
Tomoya-kun, 忘れちゃったの?
Hey, hold on, hold on. I remember you. You're Kotomi, Kotomi-chan from the Ichinose family.
Yokatta. Sokka.
She turns to my dumbfounded classmates.
Konnichiwa. Hajimemashite.
Supersonic Weapon Kotomi Mark 1 goes into serial self-introduction mode.
3年 A 組の一ノ瀬琴美です。趣味は読書です。
Her weapon of choice is the violin. Her quick draw ability allows her to go from zero to firing in only 0.2 seconds. Current number of victims countless.
バイオリンで相手を倒したことなんかないもん。
You destroyed roughly two people just now. The damage extends beyond the classroom too.
A 組うるせえぞ。とんでもない音出すね。
っていうか何？今の音怪獣？
Screams and complaints of all kinds are voiced. Footsteps muffled by campus shoes quickly approach the classroom.
お姉ちゃん、落ち着いて。
今のってもしかして琴美ちゃん？あ、やっぱりです。
あ、きょうちゃん、りょうちゃん、なぎさちゃん、みんなまとめて、こんにちは。
こんにちはじゃないわよ！
ん？ボンジュール？
違う！
ボンジュール
全然会話にならないのはなんて。
Calm down for a second. If you let her set the pace, you'll be in it in for a ride. Oh yeah.
分かってるわよ。
ay, ay, ay. She takes a deep breath. Then she decisively points at Kotomi.
あんたここで何やってんのよ。
バイオリンを弾いてるの。ちょっとだけ古ぼけているけど、とっても素敵なバイオリンなの。ふっとり。
それでは、
もう一曲。
Another song. I panic but manage to take her weapon of mass destruction away in time.
バイオリン。
Here, hold this. I hand the bow to Furukawa and the violin to Fujibayashi.
これ、どうすればいいでしょう。
Let's take them to the drama club room for now. Here we go. I pick up Kotomi and toss her over my shoulder. Retreat!
どうもお騒がせしました。
ay, ay, ay. We arrive at the drama club room and I let Kotomi down from my shoulder. You're heavier than I thought. Don't say that to a girl, man.She looks really unhappy. I know you want to play the violin, but you didn't have to come to my class. Why didn't you just wait here?
だってみんなに聞かせる前にまずともやくんに聞いてほしかったの。
She wanted him to hear it before anyone else. Those kinds of lines will make me blush, so don't say them so openly, seriously.
それにできるだけたくさんの人に聞かせてあげたいから。
I wouldn't have expected to hear that from Kotomi just a few days ago.
ちょっとだけ古ぼけているけど、とっても素敵なバイオリンなの。
Thanks to Furukawa and Fujibayashi, the violin is in its case. Kotomi must have wanted us to listen to the violin's timbre instead of her performance. This tattered old instrument had been abandoned for a long time.And was waiting for someone to play it. I see.
その程度のことで怪獣されちゃダメよ。
Someone's still angry.
ここで弾きなさい。ここで弾きなさい。
She pinches both of Kotomi's cheeks and shakes her left to right.
わかった。
むにゅ。
Kotomi nods meekly with tears in her eyes.
Wakareba yoroshi.
Demo, kino koko de renshu shite tara, hoka no bukatsu no hito tachi ga kite kureta no. Dakara, harikitte kikasete agetan dakedo, tanomu kara hoka no basho de hite kurette. Naki nagara tanomare chatta no.
Yeah, I'm sure they did.
Kawaisou ni.
Tragedy struck while we weren't looking. Anyway, we can't let any more casualties fall victim. The drama club is newly founded. No, wait, it's not even founded yet. All the more reasons to avoid any notoriety.
Demo, yappari watashi, takusan no hito ni kiite moraitai no.
I know, but with your level of skill right now.
Kono baiorin, asatte no ohiru ni wa kaesanai to ikenai no. Dakara
今のうちにできるだけたくさん弾いてあげたいの。ことみちゃん、お姉ちゃん、なんとかしてあげようよ。よし、決めた。明日の放課後、あんたのバイオリンの発表会をするから。発表会?
She tilts her head to the side in confusion。その時にはもっとたくさん人集めてあげるから。
だからそれまで他人に聞かせるのは禁止。できるだけ迷惑にならない場所を探して、そこで練習すること。わかった。
Kyo's face when she goes into that mode. Laser eyes mode. She stares off into the distance, deep in thought. She must be sifting through her memories as a musician. She finally understands what that means and nods eagerly. She quickly goes off, clutching the violin case. Do you even know where to go? The library is still open to other students and the music room is probably in use by other clubs. The school is pretty large, but there aren't that many places you can practice musical instruments without bothering anyone. Hold on, I'll go too. The moment I try to walk over, Kyo grabs my collar. Why are you bossing everyone around? Hearing that from Kyo, Kotomi unexpectedly agrees. Her words are admirable, but her gaze scares me. I never said anything like that. I think. Maybe. Their footsteps gradually disappear into the distance.
Kotomi-chan,
a monster that emits destructive supersonic waves and spreads panic everywhere she goes is accompanied by two unreliable beastmasters. They embark on a journey in search of a place to live in peace. So what are you gonna do? You promise her a recital. The one who started all of this doesn't seem to care. You have a plan? I know what you're thinking. It's impossible. You know, we always do the same things. I stretch, bending backward in the chair. Kyo inches closer to me suggestively. I answer her with a huge yawn. Now that the commotion is over, I suddenly feel really tired. Well, that's that. I'm going to sleep. Don't assault me while I'm asleep. I already had enough of that from the violin. It's now late afternoon. The two of us walk together down the slope. Next to me is a girl in the same familiar uniform.
何よ、私じゃ不満みたいね。このぐらい付き合ってくれてもいいでしょ。あんたが寝てる間、ずっと待っててあげたんだから。
That's fine. Should we really head home without the others?
あんたね、本当に甘やかしなんだから。
She says that half disappointed, half jokingly.
寮も部長もついてるんだから、大丈夫でしょ。
The fact that it's those three is what worries me. Even after spending a long time sleeping in the drama club room, Kotomi and the others never returned. I'm sure they're having some kind of weird adventure. Thanks to that, Kyo and I are now walking home together. Actually, why is Kyo even asking me to walk with her? Sometimes she does things I don't understand. She locks her fingers together and stretches backward. Still, I can tell she's glancing at me out of the corner of her eye. I've never seen that expression from Kyo before.
本当は私じゃなくて、亮がここにいるはずだったんだけどね。
What's that supposed to mean? I don't know why she's bringing up Fujibayashi.
あんたって、本当に鈍いわね。
What?
まあ、亮も消極的だから、私もいろいろ焚きつけては見たんだけどね。それで自分でも何とかしようって、ちょっとは思ったみたいなんだけど。
I can almost see the three question marks floating over my head. Kyo doesn't say much after that. Her long hair extends to her waist, caressing her surprisingly slender backside as it moves to and fro. We don't say a word the whole way back to the dorms. I think about Fujibayashi for some reason. It was during last week when Kotomi came to my class. She ran after me to return my useless school bag. Oh, I get it. You mean that Fujibayashi... Kyo, her eyes remaining locked down the slope, slowly nods.
自分じゃ言わないけどね。なんとなくわかるわよ。
She smiles faintly. This must be the face of a meddling big sister trying to take care of her baby sister.
でも、今回は相手が相手だしね。
Sorry. She looks up at me and giggles.
あのおせち料理見たとき、この子本気だって思ったし。
That thing anyone would bring that is probably insane.
バッカね。
He sure is.
おせち料理っていうのはね、普通何日もかけて作るものなのよ。あれだけのものを一人で手作りなんて、あの子下手すると徹夜してるわよ。それにあれ、全部でいくらかかると思うのよ。
You're right. I'm embarrassed to admit it, but I hadn't realized it before now.I'm too used to Kotomi's eccentric shenanigans, my real-life standards must have dropped. Is that why you told me to finish everything?
まあ、それもあるけどね。ほら、彼女が作ってくれたお弁当残すやつなんて、男じゃないでしょ?
She's not my girlfriend, and she didn't make it just for me, she wanted to eat it with everyone.
そうそう、そこなのよね。
She points at me dramatically like a detective solving a crime.
あの子って、なんていうか…ちっちゃい子供みたいなところあるでしょ?ほっとけないっていうか、母性一応恋がたきのはずの領土もすぐ仲良しになっちゃったし。なんか不思議な子よね。
Everyone who's come into contact with Kotomi feels the same way. When I first met her at the library, I had the impression that she was more like an unpredictable machine. Recently, she's been showing much more emotion and has been easier to go out with.I don't mean go out with in that way.
ま、あんたが目をつけたにしちゃ、かなりいい線じゃない?性格は妙だけど、可愛くてけなげで素直だし。お尻も胸も意外に大きいし。
Well, you would know, you checked them out.
でも、あんたも気をつけなさいよね。
About what?
あんまり人前でチヤホヤしすぎないこと。
How am I spoiling her?
本当に自覚ないわけ。
I don't know what to say.
優しくて一途な男っていうのは他の子から見ても魅力的だったりするんだからね。
Kyo? I'm happy you have feelings for me, but it's a little late to be falling in love with me. She's gonna smack him. I expected a punch for that one, so I had covered my head with my arms. I slowly look up.
ねえ、あれ、ことみじゃない?
Kyo points up ahead. We see a girl with a familiar haircut carrying an overstuffed bag.It is Kotomi. She must have already parted ways with Fujibayashi and Furukawa, as she has her usual things when going home. The only difference is that someone else is with her. It's a middle-aged man wearing a suit and a trench coat. He's facing Kotomi and is desperately trying to say something to her. Kotomi has her back to a wall and is standing perfectly still. She looks like a mannequin. Okay. Oh my god. Oh, this looks tense. We're gonna help her. I take action without thinking. I run to Kotomi's side.
Tomoya-kun.
She turns her previously expressionless face to me and cries out. Who are you? I stand in front of the man and shield Kotomi as she hides behind my back.
何か話があるなら、私が代わりにお聞きしますけど。
Kyo glares at the middle-aged man with hostility.
Yeah.
Looking more closely, the man is wearing refined spectacles. I can tell that he's confused by our sudden appearance. At the very least, he doesn't seem to be a bad person.
後日また改めて。
He says that and turns away from us. Then he walks off toward the bus route.
Kotomi, anta daijoubu datta?
She places her hands on Kotomi's shoulders and asks her with a serious tone. You're the one who does that. Never mind her. Seriously though, are you okay, Kotomi? She doesn't seem as cheerful as usual, but she nods.
で、一体何だったの、あいつ。えっと。
Hold on, he's obviously not any of those. Kyo grabs my collar and drags me to Kotomi's side. He said I'm not her boyfriend. Kyo is getting excited, but Kotomi is unusually calm. She clutches her bag close to her chest and murmurs to herself. I don't think there are a lot of those types wandering around. And why are you giving her pointers all of a sudden? I know that Kotomi never wants to talk about her home or family. There must be something she doesn't want others to know. I don't know if any of that is connected with the man from earlier though. Just calm down, Kyo. I move Kyo, still fuming, to the side. I bend my knees a little to be level with Kotomi's face. Hey, Kotomi, just answer me this. Will you be in any danger if you go home by yourself? Her expression is motionless, as if she knows something. Alright, then we'll say goodbye here.
Tomoya-kun, mata ashita.
I haven't heard that in a while. Why did you have to add it up? Yeah, she said it's okay, so it's okay. I said that in a carefree way.
Kyo-chan, mata ashita.
Mata ashita. Teiyuka, hontou ni daijoubu?
She briskly turns around. Well, bye. See you tomorrow. Kotomi walks off alone, fading into the twilight of early summer. Once Kotomi is out of sight, Kyo starts talking. Go where? I'm this way. This is an act of extortion. I seriously don't have any money.
代わりにいいこと教えてあげるから。
I doubt it's worth it.
あの子ね、本当にあんたのことが好きよ。きっと誰も代わりになれないぐらい。
Three branches sway in the same breeze that flutters Kyo's hair. Unable to respond, I look quietly at Kyo. A moment later, she's back to her usual teasing self again.
さて、大きなパフェが私を待っていると。
Kyo.
何?
Can you at least make it a small one? You'll turn into a pig.
ご忠告だけ、ありがたく受け取っとくわ。
Oh my goodness. Alright, so this is May 1st, and a good point to save and pick it up next time. Let's put the memo. There we go. Yep, that's kind of it for tonight. My voice is going coarse too. I've not been talking as much for such extended periods of time. Post game. Yeah, it's really cute. Thank you so much for being there. Let me see. Let me do this. There we go. Hey. Oh, stretchy. Oh. Yeah, I'm enjoying this route. It is indeed super cute and fun. Can't wait to see how it progresses. And we'll pick it back up on Thursday. Ah. So, yeah. Maybe. I don't know. Could be. I don't know how long it's gonna be. So I'm gonna hope we can finish it next time. But if not, we'll just keep at it. Yeah. Take care. Thanks so much for dropping by. Squid, I hope things are going okay for you. A not too chaotic day, yeah, and take things one by one, and yeah, take care of your lovely self. Thanks so much for dropping by. Oh, Squid, still at the meeting. Yeah, sending some hearts to you. There you go. There you are. Yep. I appreciate you guys. This was fun. It's nice to be back, and I'll see you again Thursday, where we'll continue this and we'll see how things go. Yes! Awesome! Good job, Squid. Yeah. Take care. See you next time. Bye bye.